Pronoun. A word that is used in place of a noun is called a pronoun. The most common pronouns are personal pronouns, which refer to the person or people speaking or writing, the person or people being spoken to, or other people or things. For example, he is planning to hide behind the door. She has many chocolates in her pocket. They are good at playing cricket. Types of pronouns. There are 10 types of pronouns. Personal pronoun, relative pronoun, interrogative pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, distributive pronoun, indefinite pronoun, reflexive pronoun, emphatic pronoun, reciprocal pronoun, exclamatory pronoun, personal pronoun. A personal pronoun is a short word used to substitute the proper name of a person. Personal pronouns are used in place of the person or people we are talking about. For example, he, she, it, him, her, we, they, them, etc. They are completing their homework. We have done it successfully. She works as a software engineer for Google. Relative pronoun. A relative pronoun is a pronoun that introduces a relative clause. It is called a relative pronoun because it relates to the word that its relative clause modifies. There are 5 basic relative pronouns: who, whom, whose, which, that. Who refers to a person. Whom refers to a person. Which refers to an animal or thing. What refers to a non-living thing. That refers to a person, animal, or thing. Interrogative pronoun. An interrogative pronoun is a pronoun used to ask a question. Like most other pronouns, interrogative pronouns replace nouns in sentences. Usually, an interrogative pronoun is the first word in an interrogative sentence, which always ends in a question mark. For example, what do you want for dinner? Which color do you prefer? Who was driving the car? Whom did you speak to? Demonstrative pronoun. A demonstrative pronoun is used to point to something specific within a sentence. These pronouns can indicate items in space or time, and they can be singular or plural. Demonstrative pronouns can be used to refer to either people, animals, or objects. For example, this was my mother's ring. That looks like the car I used to drive. These are good times. Those were the days. Distributive pronoun. Pronouns that distribute the effect of the verb on more than one person or a thing, taken one at a time, are known as distributive pronouns. Consider the following sentences. Each boy was given a medal. Each is a distributive pronoun. Either road leads to the airport. Either is a distributive pronoun. Neither accusation is true. Neither is a distributive pronoun. More examples. Either of you can take this opportunity. The teacher talked personally to each of our parents. Each of the speakers was asked to introduce himself. Indefinite pronoun. Indefinite pronouns are used when you need to refer to a person or thing that doesn't need to be specifically identified. Some common indefinite pronouns are one, other, none, some, anybody, everybody, and no one. For example, everyone was shocked by the sudden announcement. Something smells really good in the kitchen. Nobody knows about the issues I've faced. Can anyone help me? Reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronouns are words like myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, and themselves. They refer back to a person or thing. We often use reflexive pronouns when the subject and the object of a verb are the same. For example, I taught myself to play the guitar. She loves to travel herself. We thought to ourselves, this has been the best day ever. They are doing it themselves. Emphatic pronoun. Emphatic pronouns are nothing but reflexive pronouns with a changed role. The only difference is that reflexive pronouns are used after a verb, whereas emphatic pronouns are used before a verb. These are also formed by adding self, singular, or selves, plural, at the end of certain personal pronouns. For example, she herself told us the news. They themselves saw it. The city itself does not receive much rainfall. Reciprocal pronoun. We use reciprocal pronouns, each other, and one another, when two or more people do the same thing. For example, if A is talking to B, and B is talking to A, we can say that A and B are talking to each other. There are only two reciprocal pronouns, as mentioned above. For example, Kapil and Priya love each other. The coaches spoke to one another about strategy. Exclamatory pronoun. Exclamatory pronouns belong to a class of pronouns that are used to express emotions. We use exclamatory pronouns to express enthusiasm, sadness, anger, surprise, or any intense emotion. In short, these are words that are used as exclamations in a sentence. For example, what? I don't believe that. How beautiful it is. What a clean house. Thank you.